Hi, welcome to the podcast by Dr. Sushma Singh. Today we start unit the concept of education, and our topic of conversation is education as preparation for social role in ideal state. Some of the earliest ideas on the concept and meaning of education have treated it as a process by which children acquire moral values that are essential for harmonious existence in society. Both Socrates and Plato upheld that it was morality alone that ensured happiness and a sense of fulfillment in life. Moral existence, they said, was derived from the rational understanding of the virtues of human nature as also truth. Cultivation of philosophical reason, therefore, was imperative to good life. Moral reason enveloped all aspects of existence. Plato explained that since the source of intelligibility, nature, and the very being of the everything is the supreme form, a philosopher aspires to attain knowledge of it as the ultimate objective of life. Plato was conceived by a pre-bodily life in the course of which the soul gets originally acquainted with the supreme form and by implication the all-pervasive moral reasons. The task of the teacher in the classroom was limited to reminding the children and enabling them to recollect all that they innately know or are aware of. Cultivation of moral reason comes from the study of mathematics since it fosters abstraction, disciplined thinking. When abstract, disciplined thinking develops and individual is able to transcend mundane, empirical reality. Plato vehemently guarded the idea that the education is essentially the training of character. He was sure that the culture, including music, architecture, literature, provided an appropriate learning environment to the child and created an indelible impact on their minds. His concern was with the effect on characters of literature, drama, and other forms of representation that lay at the core of the Athenian education and formed the basic medium for transmission of information and ideas. He was critical of works of literature, including Homer, that failed to display respect and honor for gods, heroes, and great people who would otherwise serve as role models that children could emulate. Furthermore, he did not approve of the idea of young people enacting mean-spirited or otherwise contemptible characters in plays and drama. He felt that such people would somehow acquire the nature and character of a character they were portraying. Plato was severely criticized for his protective attitude toward the cultural education, in which the autonomy of children was laid down in favor of totalitarian ideology. In his widely read, oft-quoted work, Republic, Plato divided people in society into different categories based on their intellectual development and acumen. The major classes were the intellectual rulers or philosopher kings, the auxiliaries and military defenders, and the workers who produced goods and services. The individuals received education appropriate to the category to they belonged, which determined the task they were required to perform in the course of their lives. He devised the curriculum in that the educational needs of people in the ideal state were met appropriately. Now let us move to the second topic, education as cultivation of reasoning ability. In contrast to Plato's belief that all knowledge lies innate within the individual, Aristotle upheld that knowledge was derived from sense perceptions. A child observes the objects and phenomena through the five senses. This observation forms the basis of developing a principle or a set of principles for understanding and explaining them. The process of arriving at general conclusions from specific or particular observations is known as inductive reasoning. One example of what inductive reasoning means is that of a child who sees the buds turning into flowers over a period of few days and concludes that the rose bud in his or her garden will also turn into a flower over a period of time. Like Plato, Aristotle believed that the control of education should lie with the state. This would enable the state to employ education as a means for preparing the desired kind of citizens. He felt that the major aim of education was the cultivation of moral values and virtues. His model for moral education centered on the notion that the children acquire the traits they practice. In Aristotle's own words, "We become just by performing just acts, temperate by performing temperate ones, brave by performing brave ones." Evidently, the guidance that a child receives from parents, elders, and teachers is crucial. He said that till the age of 7, the focus of the child's education should be on physical training and character building. Between the age of 7 and 21 years, the education imparted to the child should be state controlled. In this period, gymnastic, reading, drawing, and music are the basic subjects that should be taught. Training in these subjects would prepare the children for the final period of education, which would last for their lifetime, extending beyond the walls of the school. Unlike Plato, Aristotle did not speak of higher stages of education for women. He referred to the last period of education as one of the liberal education that frees the mind from ignorance and is also the education appropriate for free men. The subjects to be studied in this period are similar to those that we believe were taught at Aristotle's lyceum, chiefly mathematics, logic, metaphysics, ethics, politics, aesthetics, music, poetry, rhetoric, physics, and biology. Here we want to close this lecture. Thank you so much. for choosing this podcast.